This conversation is all about what lies hidden underneath the surface. Over the past year, a team of researchers from Agnes and the Mustern Art Conservation Program at Queen's has been studying Rembrandt van Rijn's Head of an Old Man in a Cap. This includes so-called scanning macro X-ray fluorescence, which measures the distribution of specific elements throughout the paint layers. So, if a certain paint contains copper or lead or mercury, we can now see or map where that paint has been applied, even if that paint layer lies below the painted surface. So, that is really helpful to shed new light on the painting process and materials used. During the study, an underlying earlier composition by the artist was identified. In the cobalt map seen here, for instance, a bust in profile emerges. And this makes sense because we know from other examples that the young Rembrandt, who was only around 24 years old when he painted this work, would frequently reuse panels. His painting is paired here with recently acquired work by Toronto-based artist Erica de Freitas. The three photos on display form part of a larger series that documents the artist performing with her late grandmother's handmade doily. As she unites, as it were, these creative processes along a maternal lineage, the piece reflects on loss and grief and breath leaving the body. The fabric configurations that spill from the artist's mouth also recall the 19th century ectoplasm photographs of T.J. Hamilton, who, seeking to document the embodied interactions between mediums and the spiritual world, turned to photography, which then, of course, was at the forefront of imaging technology. Brought together, Rembrandt's and de Freitas's work bring into focus an array of tensions between studying portraits, the visible and invisible, and loss and creation.